Welcome to SCNT AV over IP Beginner's Guide. AV over IP is a powerful, flexible, and easy to operate system for you to build a matrix system in a short time. We will show you the simple setup steps in this video. SCNT AV over IP system supports a 4K 30Hz resolution, ideal for creating matrices or video walls in data transmission centers, command centers, and more. With a network switch, you can display audio and video of any signal and integrate other IP devices into the system. The two most important aspects of AV over IP configuration are setting up the switch and the transmitter. The switch needs to be adjusted to fit the over IP environment since audio and video are transmitted through the switch. On the other hand, transmitters should be assigned different channels for the matrix system to identify which source to display. Step 1, set up the switch. First, we need to configure the IGMP and jumbo frame settings of the switch. Connect the switch to a computer and open a web browser to enter the IP address of the switch. Find the IGMP and jumbo frame options and enable them. The switch configuration is complete. Step 2, set up the transmitters. Next, we need to set up the number of the channel for each transmitter. Each transmitter needs a unique channel corresponding to a specific audio-visual source. There are three methods to set up the transmitter: button/dip switch, RS-232 commands, and remote control. We will show them step by step, and you can choose the simplest setup method. You can refer to this chart to jump to a specific section. Setup via button/dip switch. Setup via the button/dip switch on the transmitter will be the simplest way. If you're using HKM02B4K, you can press the button to set the number of the channel. If you're using HKM02B and VDKM02B and have less than 15 sources, you can set the number by rotating the dip switch. For more than 15 sources, HKM02B and VDKM02B, you will need to use the RS-232 setup. Setup via RS-232 commands. Connect the power of the transmitter device. Setup via RS-232 commands requires an RS-232 to USB cable to connect the transmitter and the computer. Since RS-232 needs to be configured through a computer, ensure that your computer recognizes the transmitter. Step 1, check the COM port. Open the device manager on your computer and click on ports to see the USB COM port. You can see that the transmitter is connected to the computer's USB COM port 3. Step 2, set up transmitter parameters. We will be using the software PuTTY, but you can also use other software for RS-232 configuration. Enter the corresponding COM port number and set the baud rate of all transmitters to 115,200. Step 3, enter commands to set up the channel. Enter the command to set up the transmitter channel. Press Ctrl+M and Ctrl+J. The RS-232 software will show the channel information. Once the transmitter is set up, proceed with the next transmitter until all are configured. Set up via IR remote control. First, press the power and 7 to control the transmitters. Please cover the remote control with your hand and do not let it face the transmitter. Press menu and B to change the transmitter's mode. Then you can press the number and enter to set the channel. The number of the channel will show on the MSG display. If you are using HKM02B or VDKM02B, you will need to use PuTTY to confirm the number of the channel since there is no MSG display on the transmitter. You can refer to the previous steps to configure RS-232. Then use the remote control to input channels instead of the keyboard to input RS-232 commands. After remote control input, PuTTY will automatically display the input channel. Note, the remote control manipulates all transmitters at once. Please power on and off each device one by one until all devices are set up. Step 3, connect the receivers and devices. Finally, connect the configured transmitter to the computer device, the receiver to the monitor, and all the transmitters and receivers to the switch. If you need to use KVM, connect the mouse and keyboard to the receiver's USB ports. Pay attention to the lights on the transmitter. If the red light flashes 3 times, it means there is a channel conflict. Please check the channels to fix it. You can switch the audio and video sources through the receivers panel or the IR remote control, switching to receiver mode. We will explain more advanced settings in the next video. In this video, we have shown you how to set up and use SCNTAV over IP matrix in an extremely easy way, even for those without any network configuration background. If you have more questions, feel free to contact us or visit our website. In the next video, we will show you the advanced settings of the AV over IP system, such as TV wall, scene settings, and mobile app settings.